waters. On 1st of January, I don't know how many of you from Delhi remember, there was this massive traffic jam that actually went on for days together. Often in different metro cities in our country today, we dread that one car, that one tempo or auto that will break down on the road during peak hours and cause one traffic jam that will then go on for kilometers together. Traffic jams has become our biggest nightmare. What it also does is add to the pollution. So think about it. Will you be ready to pay a tax for congestion? Will you be ready that when you go to a congested road, to a very crowded, popular area, the government charges you a special fee called the congestion fee? Many cities, many countries do it across the world as they try and reduce traffic woes in their country. Are Indian cities ready for that? Experts say the most important thing for you to start implementing such laws and rules is to ensure that there is a strong public transport system. Metros, buses. If you have a strong transport system, then perhaps the citizens, since they have another option, can be asked. But if you don't have this, can you charge the citizen? Can you penalize the citizen because the government has failed in its job? There are two sides to it. Here's a short report on what Delhi and the centre seem to be considering right now. And we will come back and have the debate. Are Indian metros, Indian cities ready to pay congestion tax?
Massive traffic jams have crippled the capital city, and the crowd is increasing day by day. Thousands of cars adding to the toxicity that the citizens themselves breathe on a daily basis. To beat this, the centre is yet again considering a congestion tax, a fee that you will have to pay to use your vehicle in congested parts of the capital.
बिल्कुल फर्क पड़ेगा जी, टैक्स देना पड़ेगा तो उसमें जी कि गाड़ियां कम चलेगी और उस रूट पे जाना लोग कम पसंद करेंगे. जब जो उस रूट में जाएंगे तो वो टैक्स देना जरूरी होता है.
मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इज रेसिडिंग इन टू द कंजेस्टेड एरियाज, सो आई डोंट सपोर्ट दिस काइंड ऑफ एन यू नो टैक्सेशन.
ये कोई सॉल्यूशन थोड़ी है. टैक्स क्यों दें भाई, हर चीज में टैक्स लगाएंगे. खाने में टैक्स, पहनने में टैक्स, रहने में टैक्स, हर चीज में टैक्स लगा रहे हैं. टैक्स ही देते रहेंगे, मर जाएंगे और आदमी क्या करेगा.
आई थिंक गवर्नमेंट शुड थिंक मोर अबाउट क्रिएटिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर रादर देन टैक्सिंग पब्लिक ऑन द what they are doing it now.
At that purchasing of the car, government already take us road taxes, so government can't apply road taxes again.
Delhi's Lieutenant Governor Anil Baijal, along with three municipal corporations and the Urban Affairs Ministry, has zeroed in on 21 stretches in the capital where congestion tax could be imposed in a bid to ease the traffic and check pollution.
Between a certain period to a certain period, there is a congestion charge. So we are also looking at this alternative as a way to decongest some of the roads which get clogged, particularly in the peak hours.
Congestion tax, sir, it is a very good policy that has come out to reduce the congestion.
I'm glad you think so, but wait for the comments. Somebody may not think it's a good policy, but all our solutions that we have suggested are for the welfare of the citizens of Delhi.
However, no time frame has been set about when the congestion fee will be levied, how much tax will be levied on which category of vehicle, or how it will be implemented. These details are yet to be worked out.
Now, if congestion pricing, where would you do? Everywhere in the whole city, you go to any market area, whether you go to Gobindpuri, whether you go to Rajouri Garden, whether you go to Shahadra, whether you go to Lajpat Nagar, wherever you want to go, Karol Bagh, Chani Chowk, you'll find congestion. Would you put congestion tax, or would you manage to make sure that
it should run in parallel? That would at least avoid those who can avoid the trip. You see, everybody doesn't need to be on the road all the time. So people will, if they will use that stretch only if they feel it is absolutely necessary.
Soon, car owners may have to pay to use some of the congested roads in the national capital. Now, this is a plan that was suggested by the Delhi's Lieutenant Governor Anil Baijal, and this is a concept called congestion pricing, which is a very popular concept in the West, where you have to pay a toll to use some of the congested roads in the city. The big question, however, remains, how feasible is congestion pricing, a concept which is very popular and successful in countries like Singapore, London and Stockholm? Can that be effectively implemented in the national capital?
But will this new formula to control traffic in the national capital solve the problem of congestion? The debate begins now.
I have three very basic questions tonight, but the show is called The Last Word, where you, the viewer, the voter, gets to have the last word. So let's hear it from you more tonight. We'll take as many phone calls as possible. Let the government, center, and even the left-wing governor or any other government in this part of our country know what the voters want, whether they are ready to shell out a little bit more if it helps in reducing the traffic, if it helps in beating the pollution. Three questions. Is it fair to charge citizens this congestion tax? That's the first question that we will ask our panelists as well. Question number two, is congestion tax really feasible in cities like Delhi? Do we have the strong public transport system? Do we have enough connectivity between various parts so that people don't necessarily have to use their own private cars repeatedly to travel even short distances? Question number three, should the focus for the governments of the day instead be on improving public transport before they come out with odd-even schemes, before they come out with any kind of car restrictions, before they crack down on various types of car engine emissions, before they decide on a congestion tax? Should the state governments and the city authorities first focus on the public transport system? Let's say good evening to our guests. I've got Bijan Mishra. He's a citizen voice, also a consumers activist joining us this evening. I've also got Mr. K.K. Kapila, he's the chairman for Indian Roads Federation. Let me ask you, Mr. Mishra, would you be willing to pay this tax? Is it fair to ask the citizens to pay a congestion fee?
Not at all. You know, we pay enough taxes, and I don't think we need to pay more tax to take care of the welfare of the citizens. Let them first learn to use the money more efficiently before asking us to pay more tax. There is a lack of, you know, will in terms of bringing in changes. The policy makers, they only try to ape the West. In certain countries who are levying such kind of a congestion tax, they should go and see those countries first, that how beautiful they are in terms of the footpaths where citizens can walk comfortably and reach their destinations. You know, they should go and see how the public transport system, the underground rail or, you know, the metros work there. They should go and see how clean and hygienic the conditions are on the road. You know, they should first go and see all that and learn to first adopt those kind of environment or policies in our country before they start introducing congestion tax and other things like, developed countries. See, in my view, we in India, we are not prepared at all to pay such taxes because it will be discriminatory for us and you would deny us access, you know, in terms of comfort in reaching our destination or being able to lead our day-to-day life. So in my view...
All right, we seem to have lost that connection. We'll just try and fix that line with Mr. Bijan Mishra. But he's made his stand very, very clear. Let me go across to our other guest and ask him what his view is. Mr. Kapila, do you believe that citizens also have a duty? And if they want to use cars, where we're seeing a very dangerous and unprecedented increase in number of vehicles that are on our city roads right now, then perhaps they can shell out a little more and pay that tax.
Actually, I personally believe that we should first go into the cause of the congestion which is being caused in certain stretches which have been identified by the Delhi government. Most of these stretches have poor roadway systems which need to be put in place. Then we need to work on lane driving. You can ease the congestion substantially if you are able to enforce lane driving. That's something which we can do without much difficulty. It has to be taken as a challenge by the police, and the police enforcement authorities can manage it, and I'm sure we must provide them the tools of the intelligent transport system to manage it. So if we can enforce the lane driving, we probably will be able to reduce the congestion by more than 50% just by one correction on the roads. The other thing is, obviously, we need to strengthen our public transport system, particularly the bus service in Delhi. Metro has done a good job, but we need to have more parking facilities at metro stations so that people can use metro more than they are presently doing.
But you do believe that if we do that, it's a good concept that you have to sometimes take drastic steps to reduce pollution, to reduce the traffic woes, and this is a good way of doing it. It's been proven so in other cities across the world.
First, we must try and use the other tools which are available. Congestion. Okay. Should be the last resort. I mean, if you have provided for all this and then you find that the situation in a certain stretch warrants it, in particular hours, then you can have congestion tax levied during those hours in those stretches. But that certainly helps to reduce it. But you can't have a scenario where you don't provide alternative transport modes and facilities.
But look at the state. Okay, I'm going to play the devil's advocate here.
Congestion tax as a method of correcting it.
Look at the state. For example, let's take Delhi, where now significant amount of investment and effort has actually gone into building the metro system. We have multiple routes now covering a massive part of the city. We have a bus, transport system which is. Not abysmal, at least, still existing. A lot improvement can be made. We do have BRT that has been built there and implemented. Mr. Bijon Mishra, don't you think that once these systems are in place, if we are still struggling with such high amount of traffic, then perhaps it is time to think of other drastic measures?
No, absolutely. This is what I said. I said, what about the traffic police? I don't find traffic police manning in the right manner. You know, I don't find that the traffic police who have been deployed, who have been paid salary to do their work, they're doing their work. I don't find them in such places where there are possibility of congestion to manage the traffic. I don't find enough traffic police manning the traffic at that point of time. So if the traffic police is not there, and like one of my panel members mentioned, the lane driving, nobody follows in our country, which should be strictly followed, and the traffic police should be able to manage that. You know, they should be able to ensure that people follow the rules of driving. You know, they give a license, but they don't make the drivers, follow the rules of the traffic. So what my contention is, first, they should have an effective, efficient traffic policing. They should have effective, in terms of ensuring that the lane driving is enforced. They should ensure that all the tools which are there required for traffic management are in place. They should ensure that the public transport system is working, efficiently. Let me tell you my own example. I live very close to metro, but I don't take the metro because the walk from my house to the metro station is preposterous. It is so difficult to walk. There is no footpath. I have to navigate between on the road between the vehicles. And it is so risky. And I don't find it very comfortable to walk to the metro station. So when I don't find it comfortable to walk to the metro station, then I am compelled to take a taxi, or I'm compelled to take my car out of the garage, to reach my destination. So they should first try to make, things easy for people. You know, you find in Delhi, you know, they are giving permission for constructing houses, but they don't make it mandatory that you need to have parking within your building premises. They all park outside the building. You know, this is ridiculous. This only you can see in a country like India happening. And the plans get passed, the architects, the government, planning department approves all these plans and allow citizens to build and construct houses where the cars are all parked outside on the road.
Yeah.
I mean, they don't look at these issues and they start imposing tax. What is this, you know, kind of a lopsided policy making, you know, exercise is this?
Well, I don't even know if they're actually how serious they're going to be about it this time. This proposal was actually considered even during Sheila Dixit government's time.
They better not be serious.
Yes.
They better not be serious. They have to. They must roll it back. They better not be serious. They should roll it back.
But there are committees who seem to have done.
They're wasting their time. In my view, they're wasting their time.
There are committees who seem to have done some significant amount of research and then submitted their report suggesting this as one of the methods. In fact, when I was reading up on this,
it's
in the
all
evening,
bookish. It is not relevant for India.
Mr. Kapila, would you agree? It may be valid in London. It may be valid in Stockholm, but in Delhi, the routes are different. The situation is different. The scenario is different. Even the weather is different. Can similar rules be applied? If not, then
absolutely.
What is the solution?
I fully agree.
Yes.
It is important that we correct the scenario first. As I said, we need to put the roads in place. There are road stretches which have the 21 which have been brought out. There are places where there are buildings protruding on the road. Now you need to see that you straighten out the roads. You need to see that you provide the footpaths, as has been said by my colleague panelists. So you need to provide mayors which can help to take alternative transport systems. You can, as I said, provide more parking at the metro stations so that people can take their car, park at the metro station, take the metro, go to their destination, come back, pick up the car and go home. So either we add last mile connectivity in an appropriate manner, provide more parking at the stations, ensure that the lane driving is enforced. In the Commonwealth Games time, Delhi had perfect lane driving. So it is not that it is not possible to do it. It is the government has to take a conscious decision. Policing, as my friend said, you can't provide that many policemen. So what you need is provide intelligent transport systems, provide cameras which can see that if there is a person driving on the road and changing lanes and driving zigzag, he can be challenged or his vehicle can be impounded. So, you know, you have to enforce the things more with the help of the intelligent transport systems rather than providing policemen at each stretch of the road, which is not possible.
So what if all of this comes together?
More technology
the Urban Development Ministry, Mr. Kapila,
driving,
is actually looking at
more discipline on the traffic.
Yes, is actually looking at an intelligent transport system that will have a more of a, you know, electronic capturing, electronic recording. If we bring it all together. Because here is the situation on ground. Nobody can deny how drastic and how serious the pollution levels and the traffic levels are. Whether it's Mumbai, whether it's Delhi, whether it's Bengaluru. Bengaluru is so famous for his traffic jams, it's become a joke now. Something has to be done about it, even at the rate of which public transport is being now created and brought in with the metro construction and all. It doesn't look like it's solving the problem. So my question to you, Mr. Kapila, is what should be done in the immediate scenario until we perhaps come up with 10 more metro routes in the next 10 years?
No, immediate scenario in Delhi, we need to add more buses. We need to provide more connectivity to the metro stations. We need to take care of the stretches of the road where the engineering needs to be addressed. We need to ensure lane driving. Once you do that, you will find congestion is reduced substantially.
I'm just going to read out some of what our viewers are also saying. Prakash Mulchandani has actually just tweeted saying carpool should be made compulsory for those who own cars in 3 days a week. This should be monitored and fines should be imposed on who are not following. But there are several others who are actually very, very angry at this point of time that the center and the left-wing governor even suggesting this kind of attacks, just like Mr. Bijon Mishra. In fact, Sagar Prasad says the government should pay us congestion tax. This will make the government take action if money is going out of their pocket. And perhaps that's the only way to push them into doing some work into building public transport. Ganesh says if it was GST, now congestion tax, next birth tax and death tax, is this what was promised to us? Is this the Achyadin that was promised to us, Bijon Mishra? Are these all just rhetorics that, you know, authorities want to put out there to show that they're probably doing something, that they really care about the citizen issues, but at the end of the day, we don't see anything. We saw two rounds of odd even take place. And now it's just ended up being just an emergency measure.
I don't think it is necessary to impose this measure at all. To do other corrections first.
Yes, Mr. Mishra.
Yeah, I was saying that absolutely what I believe in is that you must have a long-term vision. You must also do some, you know, short-term kind of an intervention by ensuring, as I again and again saying, by ensuring that none of the vehicles are parked on the footpaths and on the roads. You have to ensure that the traffic police, and I am again saying, I am for intelligent traffic management tools and techniques, but I am also in favor of ensuring that all the manpower which is engaged in traffic policing, they efficiently work. You know, I find that most of the time, we have number of people recruited to do this work, but they're not on the spot where they're supposed to be. We don't even come to know that the number of police people who are to manage the traffic police, they're posted where and where they should be found at every point of time. I want to understand as a citizen that in my neighborhood, which policeman is supposed to be the traffic police for my neighborhood. Hmm. I want to understand that. What is his name? Where can I find him? What telephone number I can contact him? Hmm. You see, I want to know these information. These are the kind of information which should be made public. And that is the time the, you know, Lieutenant Governor should spend with citizens to understand that what are those mechanisms which are adoptable in Delhi and most friendly for the Delhiites. He should go for policies which are more friendly and more acceptable by the citizens, by consulting the citizens and not those mayors and corporates and corporators who sit in the corporation buildings and do nothing about the citizens. But so I would like to tell your viewers that please, for heaven's sake, do not support such, you know, anti-citizen measures or interventions. Raise your voice, and join Mirror now to raise the voice to ensure that such policies which are anti-citizen are rolled back and not implemented. And they don't waste their time or public time or taxpayers' money on deciding on certain policies which are not viable for our country. Okay. I would always suggest that they spend time more lucratively, more focused and effectively in the favor of the citizens by bringing the citizens on the table and consulting them like you are doing on the television show.
Well, I'm going to go on to our third question in just a bit, saying then should the focus instead be on improving public transport, because most of the cities seem to be failing on that front. But before that, let me quickly bring in another Delhi voice. Jacob is calling us from Delhi. Good evening, Jacob. What's your view?
Oh, well, I think in the long run, it's a great move. But before that, like a lot of panelists did mention, we need to create a little bit more infrastructure. We do have lovely infrastructure. The metro is great, but last mile connectivity is missing. Laws like these can be imposed, but they are unfortunately imposed on normal citizens. All the netas, the bureaucrats, the judges, they are all exempted. You can go to any of the markets in Delhi. You can go to Khan Market, Connaught Place. You can see all these people's cars parked. They don't pay a dime as parking, and they block the traffic. So you need to have a fair play. You go to a toll post, right? All these netas, they zip past it. Why are they given exemptions? It should be only for emergency vehicles, right?
Right.
So, okay, you could have the Prime Minister and the President exempted, but nobody else. They're all ordinary citizens. They are surviving on our taxpayers' money. They forget that. They become rulers. They don't become servers, right?
Yes.
So all these rules are good. Delhi is a beautiful city. Unfortunately, we citizens also take it for granted. I have a beautiful house, but I would like to park all my cars on the road, block the road in the night.
Yes.
We should penalize
that's people. A very interesting point, Jacob, that you've raised, that citizens also have a responsibility.
Absolutely.
So those who are not fulfilling their responsibility, perhaps at some point will also end up losing their right to demand their fundamental right. That's a very, very good point, Mr. Jacob. Thank you for calling us. I'm going to quickly go across to Shashank. He's calling us from Bengaluru, famous or rather infamous for its traffic woes. Shashank, will you be ready to pay the congestion tax?
I think it's a very illogical and a very ill-thought move. I mean, if you just look at what's happening right now, is that we're simply being imposed with a variety of taxes. We have the Kisan tax, which is being imposed on us, but still, you see farmer protests happening all over the country. Nothing's changed. You see the Swachh Bharat tax, which is being put on us, but, you know, Bangalore, the garden city, is now a garbage city. It's all over the place. And now we have a congestion tax after paying so much road tax for the cars we buy. I mean, even if I buy one car, I have to pay a huge amount of road tax to the government. What is the government doing with that money? And why should I pay a congestion tax because of the government's inability to manage infrastructure and public transport?
Absolutely. Shashank, thanks so much for calling us and sharing your views. I'm going to go across to our panelists and ask Mr. Kapila first. Mr. Kapila, for the government to even be in a position to say, I will charge you congestion tax, not because I need the money, but because I want to impose a slightly higher burden, hoping that people will start using cars less and thereby there will be a reduction in traffic. That's what has happened internationally, where many cities have actually seen about 10 to 12% fall in their traffic over a period of several years because of this congestion tax. Do you agree that if the government is able to provide us that kind of public transport system, then the citizens should do their part by saying, all right, you can charge us the congestion fee?
Well, I fully take your point that in case the other corrections have been put in place, government has been able to enforce the lane driving, it has been able to provide improved public transport, and if the congestion still persists and there is a requirement, one could then go back to see whether you want to impose the tax, and you should in those circumstances. But as of now, I don't think there is any point in considering imposition of this tax. They should improve these stretches. In fact, each of these stretches can be improved, and we should insist and ensure lane driving. That's the key to removal of congestion. To a very large extent, you will find immediate relief if you can bring that in there.
But you say we should insist and ensure lane driving. Look at the way we drive on our city roads.
No tax
we don't follow rules
till
the
we
minute
are provided
we see
for all these things.
We don't follow any rules the minute we see that there is no cop around. We're ready to, you know, break the traffic signal and break any traffic rule to get there first. We don't show any courtesy to people who are driving on the road at all. Unlike what is also there in other cities of the world. So then, Mr. Bijon Mishra, do citizens have no duty towards improving the environment, towards reducing the traffic? Is it fair to, when you have four cars, just because you can afford it, just because you can afford an SUV that has the worst emission quality, just because you can afford, you go around, ruining the future of our children by adding to the pollution. Where is the line? Where does the citizen's duty come into play?
You see, citizens' duty come into place when you see that there is non-discriminatory policies. You see, citizens, when they see that the netas are breaking the rules, the citizens, when they see that when well-to-do influential people break the rules and they are able to get away and not being punished, then naturally every citizen, you know, starts behaving in an indisciplined manner. So the law should be neutral, non-discriminatory, should be, you know, unbiased. You know, so what I am all the time trying to say is that the law enforcing agencies, all these traffic police people, should be trained in such a manner, and they should be encouraged to see that even if it's a neta, he gets fined and he gets punished, and he gets punished in public, like we get ticket when we jump a traffic rule. We get a ticket right away. So why can't those netas get a ticket right away? You know, that's the issue, and that is what we are trying to say.
You know,
that is why I am saying that
there
has to be a very efficient.
Just go ahead, please finish your point.
No, I finished my point. Yes. What I am all the time trying to say, that you have to go step by step.
Yes.
You can't come in and start saying, I'll impose a tax, without they doing their job, which they're supposed to do.
Yes.
If they do their job well, and then we as citizens, we are not allowing them to do their job well, then of course you have all the right to impose tax or fine or punish us.
Well
but
said, well they said. I wanted you to highlight
because
that
they're inefficient,
because
they pass
often
on.
We are told that, you know, we sit here and consistently demand and question the state. We sit here and consistently talk about our fundamental rights, but we do not factor in what is our duty as a citizen. Now, our duty as a citizen will also come into play, and it does, wherever it is needed. But it is the job of the state to first provide us the basic facilities, to first provide us the basic public transport before they question us for using those number of cars and using those SUVs on the roads. I have one more caller on the phone, and I completely am loving the fact that our team has told us that we are getting calls from across the country. This may be a proposal that the left-wing governor is considering right now in Delhi. This may be a proposal that the center has thought about and spoken to the Delhi authorities about. But it is something that every citizen in our metro cities will sit and think about. Will this solve my problem? And if it does, then can I use the public transport and not use my car? That's the big question. Karunakaran is on the phone line. Good evening. Go ahead, please.
Hello.
Hi. Go ahead.
Yeah. I asked there last time that now the elected representative government is there. How governor is, lieutenant governor is proposing such taxes without consent of the elected representatives government. Second, this tax, then again this tax is only for road users or vehicle owner, or the ordinary pedestrian also have to pay the tax for the congested road.
Okay, no, Mr. Karunakaran, here is how it is. Right now it's in a consideration stage. Experts have been asked to give their views, so we don't know exactly how they're going to charge you congestion fee, if they do, and what amount they will. It will only be for vehicles, it will not be for pedestrians at all. What they will look at doing initially is perhaps look at specific roads. So, in fact, I had a list that had been given to me by the team, by my team, that talks about certain areas in Delhi itself which are more congested, and perhaps the experimentation will begin there. So, if they are highly congested areas, that is where they will, at entry and exit points, try and charge you for it. Whether it's a corridor between Aurobindo Chowk and Andheria, or the Nehru Place flyover to Modi Mills flyover, whether it's the ITO intersection, no, parts of the Mehrauli Gurgaon road. These are examples of Delhi. Of course, different cities may look at different choking points where there is a lot of traffic, and to reduce that traffic, put a fee over there. Mr. Bijan Mishra, you wanted to come in and say something?
No, I am only trying to say that you are supposed to bring policies, as I again and again saying, to make life comfortable for the citizens. You cannot bring in a policy which will make us uncomfortable. You see, so if you do that, then naturally the citizens will react and they will not accept it. So, you know, if you look at the developed countries,
yes,
and when you see how they impose these congestion charges, they make sure that most of the citizens are not put into inconvenience by that, but they ensure that by putting that tax, they make things more comfortable for the citizens.
Yes, absolutely. So London, charges a congestion fee about 11.5 pounds to its citizens. On weekdays, that's the congestion fee. But if you go to that city, at no point will you have to struggle in terms of travel due to lack of public transport. Wherever you have to go, if you take the train system, the metro system from one station to the other, you will perhaps have to walk down another 5 or 10 minutes and you will be at your destination. That is the level of public transport that our governments need to give us before they start asking us to pay any kind of congestion tax. As far as construction of roads is concerned, we are already paying taxes to our authorities. But if it is a move to reduce traffic, build the public transport system. In Delhi, there was a period of 7 years where no new buses were ordered. Can you imagine the state of the national capital where no new buses came into the system for over 5 to 7 years? That is the state of affairs in our metro cities. In Bengaluru, even if you have to go, yes, a distance of 2 kilometers, you struggle with public transport. You struggle even with the rickshawwala to get to that point. You have no option but to have your own vehicle. That is the state of public transport in our cities. So until and unless our states can actually give us that, I don't think they should even think of demanding an additional charge from the citizens. I thank both our panelists for joining us on this debate tonight. Thank you, voters, for expressing your views as well. Majority of those who wrote in to us and called are definitely in no mood to shell out extra when they aren't getting what they deserve already. Thanks so much.